Jeremiah 17:14. Heal me, O Lord, and I will be healed. Save me, and I will be saved. For you are the one I praise. Hebrews 6:19. We have this hope as an anchor for the soul, firm and secure. Isaiah 41:10. So do not fear, for I am with you. Do not be dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you and help you. I will uphold you with my righteous right hand. Isaiah 53:4-5. Surely he took up our pain and bore our suffering. Yet we considered him punished by God, stricken by him, and afflicted. But he was pierced for our transgressions. He was crushed for our iniquities. The punishment that brought us peace was on him, and by his wounds we are healed. Jeremiah 30:17. But I will restore you to health and heal your wounds, declares the Lord. Deuteronomy 32:39. See now that I myself am he. There is no God besides me. I put to death and I bring to life. I have wounded and I will heal, and no one can deliver out of my hand. Exodus 15:26. For I am the Lord who heals you. Philippians 4:19. And my God will meet all your needs according to the riches of his glory in Christ Jesus. 3 John 1:2. Beloved, I pray that you may prosper in all things and be in health, just as your soul prospers. Matthew 9:35. Jesus went about all the cities and villages, teaching in their synagogues, preaching the gospel of the kingdom, and healing every sickness and every disease among the people. Luke 8:50. Hearing this, Jesus said to Jairus, "Don't be afraid, just believe, and she will be healed." Mark 1:41. Jesus was indignant. He reached out his hand and touched the man. "I am willing," he said, "be clean." Luke 6:19. The whole multitude sought to touch him, for power went out from him and healed them all. Hebrews 13:8. Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. Psalm 103:2-3. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits, who forgives all your iniquities, who heals all your diseases. Isaiah 53:5. He was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement for our peace was upon him, and by his stripes we are healed. Jeremiah 17:14. Heal me, O Lord, and I shall be healed. Save me, and I shall be saved, for you are my praise. Proverbs 4:20-22. My son, give attention to my words. Incline your ear to my sayings. Do not let them depart from your eyes. Keep them in the midst of your heart, for they are life to those who find them, and health to all their flesh. Psalm 107:20. He sent his word and healed them and delivered them from their destructions. James 5:14-15. Is anyone among you sick? Let him call for the elders of the church, and let them pray over him, anointing him with oil in the name of the Lord. And the prayer of faith will save the sick, and the Lord will raise him up. And if he has committed sins, he will be forgiven. Mark 16:17-18. And these signs will follow those who believe. In my name, they will cast out demons. They will speak with new tongues. They will take up serpents. And if they drink anything deadly, it will by no means hurt them. They will lay hands on the sick, and they will recover. Isaiah 57:18-19. I have seen their ways, but I will heal them. I will guide them and reward them with comfort. And for those who mourn, I will create reason for praise, utter prosperity to those far and near, and I will heal them, says the Lord. Psalm 103:2-3. Let my whole being bless the Lord and never forget all his good deeds. How God forgives all your sins, heals all your sickness. Proverbs 16:24. Pleasant words are flowing honey, sweet to the taste, and healing to the bones. James 5:16. Therefore, confess your sins to each other and pray for each other so that you may be healed. The prayer of a righteous person is powerful and effective. Isaiah 58:8. Then your light will break forth like the dawn, and your healing will quickly appear. Then your righteousness will go before you, and the glory of the Lord will be your rear guard. Jeremiah 3:22. My wayward children, says the Lord, come back to me, and I will heal your wayward hearts. Proverbs 3:7-8. Do not be wise in your own eyes. Fear the Lord and shun evil. This will bring health to your body and nourishment to your bones. Hosea 14:4. I will heal their apostasy. I will love them freely, for my anger has turned away from them. Lamentations 3:22-25. The Lord's loving kindnesses indeed never cease, for his compassions never fail. They are new every morning. Great is your faithfulness. The Lord is my portion, says my soul. Therefore, I have hope in him. The Lord is good to those who wait for him, to the person who seeks him. Hebrews 10:23. Let us hold fast the confession of our hope without wavering, for he who promised is faithful. Psalm 105. For the Lord is good, his loving kindness is everlasting, his faithfulness to all generations. Psalm 91:4. He will cover you with his pinions, and under his wings you may seek refuge. His faithfulness is a shield and bulwark. 1 Kings 8:56. Blessed be the Lord, who has given rest to his people Israel, according to all that he promised. Not one word has failed of all his good promise, which he promised through Moses, his servant. Isaiah 25:1. O Lord, you are my God. I will exalt you. I will give thanks to your name, for you have worked wonders, plans formed long ago with perfect faithfulness. Exodus 15:26. For I am the Lord who heals you. Revelation 19:11. And I saw heaven opened, and behold, a white horse, and he who sat on it is called Faithful and True, and in righteousness he judges and wages war. 1 Corinthians 1:9. God is faithful, through whom you were called into fellowship with his Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. 1 Peter 2:24. He personally carried our sins in his body on the cross so that we can be dead to sin and live for what is right. By his wounds you are healed. Isaiah 53:5. But he was pierced for our rebellion, crushed for our sins. He was beaten so we could be whole. He was whipped so we could be healed. Psalm 103, 2 through 3. Let all that I am praise the Lord. May I never forget the good things He does for me. He forgives all my sins and heals all my diseases. Matthew 8:7. Jesus said to him, I will come and heal him. Jeremiah 33:6. Behold, I will bring to it health and healing. I will heal them, and I will reveal to them an abundance of peace and truth. Jeremiah 30:17. I will restore your health, and I will heal your wounds, declares the Lord. Psalm 107:20. He sent out his word and healed them. He rescued them from the grave. Acts 10:38. You know of Jesus of Nazareth, how God anointed him with the Holy Spirit and with power, and how he went about doing good and healing all who were oppressed by the devil, for God was with him. Acts 1:8. But you shall receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you, and you shall be witnesses to me in Jerusalem and in all Judea and Samaria and to the end of the earth. Romans 15:13. Now may the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace in believing, that you may abound in hope by the power of the Holy Spirit. Galatians 5:25. If we live in the Spirit, let us also walk in the Spirit. Acts 3:16. And on the basis of faith in his name, it is the name of Jesus which has strengthened this man whom you see and know. And the faith which comes through him has given him this perfect health in the presence of you all. Matthew 10:8. Heal the sick, raise the dead, cleanse the lepers, cast out demons. Freely you received, freely give. Ephesians 6:23. Peace be to the brethren, and love with faith from God the Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. Matthew 15:28. Then Jesus said to her, O woman, your faith is great. It shall be done for you as you wish. And her daughter was healed at once. Matthew 9:29. Then he touched their eyes, saying, It shall be done to you according to your faith. John 11:6. But when Jesus heard this, he said, This sickness is not to end in death, but for the glory of God, so that the Son of God may be glorified by it. 2 Thessalonians 3:16. Now may the Lord of peace himself give you peace at all times, in every way. The Lord be with you all. Philippians 4:6. Do not be anxious about anything, but in every situation, by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, present your requests to God. Psalm 34:19. The righteous person may have many troubles, but the Lord delivers him from them all. Isaiah 41:10. So do not fear, for I am with you. Do not be dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you and help you. I will uphold you with my righteous right hand. Revelation 21:4. He will wipe every tear from their eyes. There will be no more death, or mourning, or crying, or pain, for the old order of things has passed away. Matthew 9:35. Jesus went through all the towns and villages, teaching in their synagogues, proclaiming the good news of the kingdom, and healing every disease and sickness. Luke 8:50. Hearing this, Jesus said to Jairus, Don't be afraid, just believe, and she will be healed. Mark 1:41. Jesus was indignant. He reached out his hand and touched the man. I am willing, he said, be clean. Luke 9:1-2. And he called the 12 together and gave them power and authority over all the demons and to heal diseases. And he sent them out to proclaim the kingdom of God and to perform healing. Exodus 15:26. For I am the Lord who heals you. Malachi 4:2. But for you who fear my name, the Sun of Righteousness will rise with healing in its wings, and you will go forth and skip about like calves from the stall. Isaiah 38:16-17. Lord, by such things people live, and my spirit finds life in them too. You restored me to health and let me live. Surely it was for my benefit that I suffered such anguish. In your love, you kept me from the pit of destruction. You have put all my sins behind your back. Psalm 147:3. He heals the brokenhearted and binds up their wounds. Acts 10:38. How God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and power, and how he went around doing good and healing all who were under the power of the devil, because God was with him. Matthew 11:28-29. Then Jesus said, "Come to me, all of you who are weary and carry heavy burdens, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you. Let me teach you, because I am humble and gentle at heart, and you will find rest for your souls." Jeremiah 30:17. For I will restore health to you, and your wounds I will heal, declares the Lord. Mark 2:17. Then Jesus said to her, "Daughter, your faith has healed you. Go in peace and be freed from your suffering." Matthew 8:13. And Jesus said to the centurion, "Go, it shall be done for you as you have believed." And the servant was healed that very moment. Jeremiah 33:6. Behold, I will bring to it health and healing, and I will heal them and reveal to them abundance of prosperity and security. Ecclesiastes 3:1-3. For everything there is a season, and a time for every matter under heaven. A time to be born, and a time to die. A time to plant, and a time to pluck up what is planted. A time to kill, and a time to heal. A time to break down, and a time to build up. Psalm 41:3. The Lord will sustain him upon his sickbed. In his illness, you restore him to health. Psalm 103:1-5. Praise the Lord, my soul, all my inmost being. Praise his holy name. Praise the Lord, my soul, and forget not all his benefits, who forgives all your sins and heals all your diseases, who redeems your life from the pit and crowns you with love and compassion, who satisfies your desires with good things so that your youth is renewed like the eagles. Philippians 4:6-7. Do not be anxious about anything, but in every situation, by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, present your requests to God, and the peace of God, which transcends all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. Matthew 11:28. Come to me, all who are weary and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. John 14:27. Peace I leave with you. My peace I give you. I do not give to you as the world gives. Do not let your hearts be troubled, and do not be afraid. Colossians 1:11. May you be strengthened with all power, according to his glorious might, with all endurance and patience, with joy. 1 Peter 5:7. Casting all your anxieties on him, because he cares for you. Deuteronomy 31, 8 through 9. The Lord himself goes before you and will be with you. He will never leave you nor forsake you. Do not be afraid. Do not be discouraged. Matthew 19, 26. But Jesus looked at them and said, "With man this is impossible, but with God all things are possible." Psalm 46, 1 through 3. God is our refuge and strength, an ever-present help in trouble. Therefore, we will not fear, though the earth give way and the mountains fall into the heart of the sea, though its waters roar and foam and the mountains quake with their surging. Psalm 23, 4. Even though I walk through the darkest valley, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. Romans 8, 38 through 39. No, in all these things we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. For I am convinced that neither death nor life, neither angels nor demons, neither the present nor the future, nor any powers, neither height nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God that is in Christ Jesus our Lord. 1 Thessalonians 5, 16 through 18. Rejoice always, pray without ceasing, give thanks in all circumstances, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus for you. Psalm 119, 7, 6. May your unfailing love be my comfort, according to your promise to your servant. Psalm 27, 1. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the stronghold of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? Psalm 116, 1 through 2. I love the Lord, for he heard my voice. He heard my cry for mercy. Because he turned his ear to me, I will call on him as long as I live. Romans 15, 13. May the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace as you trust in him, so that you may overflow with hope by the power of the Holy Spirit. Hebrews 6, 19. We have this hope as an anchor for the soul, firm and secure. Romans 8, 24 through 25. For in this hope we were saved. Now hope that is seen is not hope, for who hopes for what he sees? But if we hope for what we do not see, we wait for it with patience. 2 Corinthians 4, 16 through 18. Therefore, we do not lose heart, though outwardly we are wasting away, yet inwardly we are being renewed day by day. For our light and momentary troubles are achieving for us an eternal glory that far outweighs them all. So we fix our eyes not on what is seen, but on what is unseen. Since what is seen is temporary, but what is unseen is eternal. Psalm 33:22. Let your unfailing love be with us, Lord, even as we put our hope in you. Psalm 32:7-8. You are my hiding place. You will protect me from trouble and surround me with songs of deliverance. I will instruct you and teach you in the way you should go. I will counsel you with my loving eye on you. Hebrews 12:1-2. And let us run with perseverance the race marked out for us, fixing our eyes on Jesus, the pioneer and perfecter of faith. For the joy set before him, he endured the cross, scorning its shame, and sat down at the right hand of the throne of God. Isaiah 38:17. Surely it was for my benefit that I suffered such anguish. In your love, you kept me from the pit of destruction. You have put all my sins behind your back. Isaiah 40:29. He gives strength to the weary and increases the power of the weak. Psalm 32. Lord, my God, I called to you for help, and you healed me. Psalms 107:20-21. He sent out his word and healed them. He rescued them from the grave. Let them give thanks to the Lord for his unfailing love and his wonderful deeds for mankind. Psalm 121:1-2. I lift up my eyes to the hills. From where does my help come? My help comes from the Lord who made the heaven and earth. Isaiah 43:1-2. Do not fear, for I have redeemed you. I have summoned you by name. You are mine. When you pass through the waters, I will be with you. And when you pass through the rivers, they will not sweep over you. When you walk through the fire, you will not be burned. The flames will not set you ablaze. Romans 5:5. And hope does not put us to shame, because God's love has been poured out into our hearts through the Holy Spirit who has been given to us. Psalm 46:8. The Lord opens the eyes of the blind. The Lord raises up those who are bowed down. The Lord loves the righteous. Psalms 9:9-10. The Lord is a refuge for the oppressed, a stronghold in times of trouble. Those who know your name trust in you, for you, Lord, have never forsaken those who seek you. Psalm 62:1-2. Truly my soul finds rest in God. My salvation comes from him. Truly he is my rock and my salvation. He is my fortress. I will not be shaken. Ephesians 2:6-7. And God raised us up with Christ and seated us with him in heavenly realms in Christ Jesus, in order that in the coming ages he might show the incomparable riches of his grace expressed in his kindness to us in Christ Jesus. Psalm 145:18-19. The Lord is near to all who call on him, to all who call on him in truth. He fulfills the desires of those who fear him. He hears their cry and saves them. Psalm 94:19. When my anxious thoughts multiply within me, your consolations delight my soul. Psalm 16:8. I keep my eyes always on the Lord. With him at my right hand, I will not be shaken. Matthew 9:35. Jesus was going through all the cities and villages, teaching in their synagogues, in proclaiming the gospel of the kingdom, and healing every kind of disease and every kind of sickness. Matthew 8:16. When evening came, they brought to him many who were demon-possessed, and he cast out the spirits with a word and healed all who were ill. Matthew 14:14. When he went ashore, he saw a large crowd and felt compassion for them and healed their sick. Matthew 14:36. And they implored him that they might just touch the fringe of his cloak, and as many as touched it were cured. Matthew 15:30. And large crowds came to him, bringing with them those who were lame, crippled, blind, mute, and many others, and they laid them down at his feet, and he healed them. Luke 9:11. But the crowds were aware of this and followed him, and welcoming them, he began speaking to them about the kingdom of God and curing those who had need of healing. Isaiah 53:5. But he was pierced through for our transgressions. He was crushed for our iniquities. The chastening for our well-being fell upon him, and by his scourging we are healed. 1 Peter 2:24. And he himself bore our sins in his body on the cross, so that we might die to sin and live to righteousness. For by his wounds you were healed. Matthew 4, 24. The news about him spread throughout all Syria, and they brought to him all who were ill, those suffering with various diseases and pains, demoniacs, epileptics, paralytics, and he healed them. Matthew 8:8. But the centurion said, Lord, I am not worthy for you to come under my roof, but just say the word, and my servant will be healed. Matthew 9:21. For she was saying to herself, if I only touch his garment, I will get well. Luke 6:19. And all the people were trying to touch him, for power was coming from him and healing them all. Luke 5:15. But the news about him was spreading even farther, and large crowds were gathering to hear him and to be healed of their sicknesses. Luke 9:11. But the crowds were aware of this and followed him, and welcoming them, he began speaking to them about the kingdom of God and curing those who had need of healing. Mark 10:52. And Jesus said to him, go, your faith has made you well. Immediately he regained his sight and began following him on the road. Luke 17:19. And he said to him, stand up and go, your faith has made you well. Luke 8:48. And he said to her, daughter, your faith has made you well. Go in peace. Matthew 8:15. He touched her hand, and the fever left her, and she got up and waited on him. Matthew 10:1. Jesus summoned his 12 disciples and gave them authority over unclean spirits to cast them out and to heal every kind of disease and every kind of sickness. Acts 3:6-8. But Peter said, I do not possess silver and gold, but what I do have I give to you. In the name of Jesus Christ the Nazarene, walk. And seizing him by the right hand, he raised him up, and immediately his feet and his ankles were strengthened. And with a leap he stood upright and began to walk, and he entered the temple with them, walking and leaping and praising God. Acts 15:16. To such an extent that they even carried the sick out into the streets and laid them on cots and pallets, so that when Peter came by, at least his shadow might fall on any one of them. Also, the people from the cities in the vicinity of Jerusalem were coming together, bringing people who were sick or afflicted with unclean spirits, and they were all being healed. Acts 9:34. Peter said to him, Ananias, Jesus Christ heals you. Get up and make your bed. Immediately he got up. Acts 14:9-10. This man was listening to Paul as he spoke, who, when he had fixed his gaze on him and had seen that he had faith to be made well, said with a loud voice, stand upright on your feet. And he leaped up and began to walk. Romans 10:17. So faith comes from hearing, and hearing by the word of Christ. John 6:63. The Spirit gives life. The flesh counts for nothing. The words I have spoken to you are spirit, and they are life. 2 Corinthians 4:13. It is written, I believed, therefore I have spoken. With that same spirit of faith, we also believe, and therefore speak. 1 Corinthians 2:4-5. My message and my preaching were not with wise and persuasive words, but with a demonstration of the Spirit's power, so that your faith might not rest on men's wisdom, but on God's power. Psalm 68:34-35. To him who rides on the heaven of heavens, which were of old. Indeed, he sends out his voice, a mighty voice, ascribes strength to God. His excellent is over Israel, and his strength is in the clouds. O God, you are more awesome than your holy places. The God of Israel is he who gives strength and power to his people. Blessed be God. Psalm 68:28. Summon your power, O God. Show us your strength, O God, as you have done before. Mark 11:22-23. And Jesus answering saith unto them, Have faith in God. For verily I say unto you, that whosoever shall say unto this mountain, Be thou removed, and be thou cast into the sea, and shall not doubt in his heart, but shall believe that those things which he saith shall come to pass, he shall have whatsoever he saith. 1 John 15:14-15. This is the confidence we have in approaching God, that if we ask anything according to his will, he hears us. And if we know that he hears us, whatever we ask, we know that we have what we asked of him. Psalm 107:20. He sent his word and healed them and delivered them from their destructions. Proverbs 3:8. It will be healing to your body and refreshment to your bones. Psalm 103:3. Who pardons all your iniquities, who heals all your diseases. Psalm 146:8. The Lord gives sight to the blind. The Lord lifts up those who are bowed down. The Lord loves the righteous. 2 Kings 20:25. This is what the Lord, the God of your father David, says. I have heard your prayer and seen your tears. I will heal you. Luke 6:19. And the people all tried to touch him, because power was coming from him and healing them all. Jeremiah 30:17. But I will restore you to health and heal your wounds, declares the Lord. 1 Peter 20:24. He himself bore our sins in his body on the cross, so that we might die to sins and live for righteousness. By his wounds you have been healed. Exodus 23:25. Worship the Lord your God, and his blessing will be on your food and water. I will take away sickness from among you. Matthew 11:28. Come to me, all who are weary and burdened, and I will give you rest. Matthew 9:20-22. And a woman who had been suffering from a hemorrhage for 12 years came up behind him and touched the fringe of his cloak. For she was saying to herself, If I only touch his garment, I will get well. But Jesus, turning and seeing her, said, Daughter, take courage. Your faith has made you well. And at once the woman was made well. Luke 6:19. And all the people were trying to touch him, for power was coming from him and healing them all. Matthew 21:14. And the blind and the lame came to him in the temple, and he healed them. Luke 4:40. While the sun was setting, all those who had any who were sick with various diseases brought them to him, and laying his hands on each one of them, he was healing them. Acts 14:8-10. At Lystra, a man was sitting who had no strength in his feet, lame from his mother's womb, who had never walked. This man was listening to Paul as he spoke, who, when he had fixed his gaze on him and had seen that he had faith to be made well, said with a loud voice, Stand upright on your feet. And he leaped up and began to walk. Acts 19:11-2. God was performing extraordinary miracles by the hands of Paul, so that handkerchiefs or aprons were even carried from his body to the sick, and the diseases left them, and the evil spirits went out. 1 Corinthians 12:2. 8 through 9. For to one is given the word of wisdom through the Spirit, and to another the word of knowledge according to the same Spirit, to another faith by the same Spirit, and to another gifts of healing by the one Spirit. Mark 16:17-18. These signs will accompany those who have believed. In my name they will cast out demons. They will speak with new tongues. They will pick up serpents. And if they drink any deadly poison, it will not hurt them. They will lay hands on the sick, and they will recover. 1 Corinthians 12:28. And God has appointed in the church first apostles, second prophets, third teachers, then miracles, then gifts of healings, helps, administrations, various kinds of tongues. Luke 9:1-6. And he called the 12 together and gave them power and authority over all the demons and to heal their diseases. And he sent them out to proclaim the kingdom of God and to perform healing. And he said to them, take nothing for your journey, neither a staff, nor a bag, nor bread, nor money. And do not have two tunics apiece. Whatever house you enter, stay there until you leave that city. And as for those who do not receive you, as you go out from that city, shake the dust off your feet as a testimony against them. Departing, they began going throughout the villages, preaching the gospel and healing everywhere. Luke 10:9. And heal those in it who are sick, and say to them, the kingdom of God has come near to you. Luke 9:2. And he sent them out to proclaim the kingdom of God and to perform healing. Genesis 20:17. Then Abraham prayed to God, and God healed Abimelech, his wife, and his female slaves, so they could have children again. 2 Kings 20:5. Go back and tell Hezekiah, the ruler of my people, this is what the Lord, the God of your father David, says. I have heard your prayer and seen your tears, and I will heal you. Psalm 103:2-3. Praise the Lord, my soul, and forget not all his benefits, who forgives all your sins and heals all your diseases. Matthew 8:16-17. When evening came, many who were demon-possessed were brought to him, and he drove out the spirits with a word and healed all the sick. This was to fulfill what was spoken through the prophet Isaiah. He took up our infirmities and bore our diseases. Matthew 4:24. News about him spread all over Syria, and people brought to him all who were ill with various diseases, those suffering severe pain, the demon-possessed, those having seizures, and the paralyzed, and he healed them all. Matthew 9:27-30. As Jesus went on from there, two blind men followed him, calling out, have mercy on us, Son of David. When he had gone indoors, the blind men came to him, and he asked them, do you believe that I am able to do this? Yes, Lord, they replied. Then he touched their eyes and said, according to your faith, let it be done to you. And their sight was restored. Matthew 14:14. When Jesus landed and saw a large crowd, he had compassion on them and healed their sick. Matthew 14:35-36. And when the men of that place recognized Jesus, they sent word to all the surrounding country. People brought all their sick to him and begged him to let the sick just touch the edge of his cloak, and all who touched it were healed. Mark 40:41. And a leper came to Jesus, beseeching him, and falling on his knees before him, and saying, if you are willing, you can make me clean. Moved with compassion, Jesus stretched out his hand and touched him, and said to him, I am willing, be cleansed. Luke 6:19. And the people all tried to touch him, because power was coming from him, and healing them all. Luke 8 49 through 50. While Jesus was still speaking, someone came from the house of Jairus, the synagogue leader. "Your daughter is dead," he said. "Don't bother the teacher anymore." Hearing this, Jesus said to Jairus, "Don't be afraid. Just believe, and she will be healed." Luke 18:41-42. "What do you want me to do for you?" "Lord, I want to see," he replied. Jesus said to him, "Receive your sight. Your faith has healed you." Luke 17:20-19. As he was going into a village, 10 men who had leprosy met him. They stood at a distance and called out in a loud voice, "Jesus, Master, have pity on us." When he saw them, he said, "Go, show yourselves to the priests." And as they went, they were cleansed. One of them, when he saw he was healed, came back, praising God in a loud voice. He threw himself at Jesus' feet and thanked him, and he was a Samaritan. Jesus asked, "Were not all 10 cleansed? Where are the other 9? Has no one returned to give praise to God except this foreigner?" Then he said to him, "Rise and go. Your faith has made you well." Luke 9:1-2 and 10:9. When Jesus had called the 12 together, he gave them power and authority to drive out all demons and to cure diseases. And he sent them out to proclaim the kingdom of God and to heal the sick who are there, and tell them, "The kingdom of God has come near to you." Acts 3:1-8. One day, Peter and John were going up to the temple at the time of prayer at 3 p.m. Now a man who was lame from birth was being carried to the temple gate called Beautiful, where he was put every day to beg from those going into the temple courts. When he saw Peter and John about to enter, he asked them for money. Peter looked straight at him, as did John. Then Peter said, "Look at us." So the man gave them his attention, expecting to get something from them. Then Peter said, "Silver or gold I do not have, but what I do have I give you. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, walk." Taking him by the right hand, he helped him up, and instantly the man's feet and ankles became strong. He jumped to his feet and began to walk. Then he went with him into the temple courts, walking and jumping and praising God. Acts 3:16. By faith in the name of Jesus, this man whom you see and know was made strong. It is Jesus' name and the faith that comes through him that has completely healed him, as you can all see. Acts 5:12-15-16. The apostles performed many signs and wonders among the people. People brought the sick into the streets and laid them on beds and mats, so that at least Peter's shadow might fall on some of them as he passed by. Crowds gathered also from the towns around Jerusalem, bringing their sick and those tormented by impure spirits, and all of them were healed. Acts 8:5-7. Then Philip went down to the city of Samaria and preached Christ to them. And the multitudes with one accord heeded the things spoken by Philip, hearing and seeing the miracles which he did. For unclean spirits, crying with a loud voice, came out of many who were possessed, and many who were paralyzed and lame were healed. Acts 28:7-9. There was an estate nearby that belonged to Publius, the chief official of the island. He welcomed us to his home and showed us generous hospitality for 3 days. His father was sick in bed, suffering from fever and dysentery. Paul went in to see him and, after prayer, placed his hands on him and healed him. When this had happened, the rest of the sick on the island came and were cured. Matthew 4:23-24. Jesus went throughout Galilee, teaching in their synagogues, preaching the good news of the kingdom, and healing every disease and sickness among the people. News about him spread over all Syria, and people brought to him all who were ill with various diseases, those suffering severe pain and the demon-possessed, those having seizures, and the paralyzed, and he healed them all. Exodus 23:25-26. Worship the Lord your God, and his blessing will be on your food and water. I will take away sickness from among you, and none will miscarry or be barren in your land. I will give you a full lifespan. Exodus 23:25-26. Worship the Lord your God, and his blessing will be on your food and water. I will take away your sickness from among you, and none will miscarry or be barren in your land. I will give you a full lifespan. Isaiah 53:5. But he was pierced for our transgressions. He was crushed for our iniquities. The punishment that brought us peace was upon him, and by his wounds we are healed. 1 Peter 20:24. He himself bore our sins in his body on the tree, so that we might die to sins and live for righteousness. For by his wounds you have been healed. Matthew 21:22. If you believe, you will receive whatever you ask for in prayer. Matthew 8:16-17. When the even was come, they brought unto him many that were possessed with devils, and he cast out the spirits with his word, and healed all that were sick, that it might be fulfilled which was spoken by Isaiah the prophet, saying, himself took our infirmities and bare our sicknesses. Matthew 14:35-36. And when the men of that place had knowledge of Jesus, they sent out into all that country round about, and brought unto him all that were diseased, and besought him that they might only touch the hem of his garment, and as many as touched were made perfectly whole. Mark 1:40-41. A man with leprosy came to him, and begged him on his knees, if you are willing, you can make me clean. Filled with compassion, Jesus reached out his hand and touched the man. I am willing, he said, be clean. Matthew 9:20-22 and 27-30. And behold, a woman which was diseased with an issue of blood 12 years came behind him, and touched the hem of his garment. For she said within herself, if I may but touch his garment, I shall be made whole. But Jesus turned him about, and when he saw her, he said, daughter, be of good comfort, thy faith hath made thee whole. And the woman was made whole from that hour. And when Jesus departed thence, 2 blind men followed him, crying and saying, thou son of David, have mercy on us. And when he was come into the house, the blind men came to him, and Jesus saith unto them, believe ye that I am able to do this? They said unto him, yea, Lord. Then touched he their eyes, saying, according to your faith be it unto you. And their eyes were opened. Acts 3:16. By faith in the name of Jesus, this man whom you see and know was made strong. It is Jesus' name and the faith that comes through him that has given this complete healing to him, as you can all see. Acts 9:10-11 and 17-18. And there was a certain disciple at Damascus named Ananias, and to him said the Lord in a vision, Ananias. And he said, behold, I am here, Lord. And the Lord said unto him, arise, and go into the street which is called Straight, and inquire in the house of Judas for one called Saul of Tarsus. And Ananias went his way, and entered into the house, and putting his hands on him, said, brother Saul, the Lord, even Jesus, that appeared unto thee in the way as thou camest, hath sent me that thou mightest receive thy sight and be filled with the Holy Ghost. And immediately there fell from his eyes as it had been scales, and he received sight forthwith, and arose and was baptized. John 6-7. Having said this, he spit on the ground, made some mud with saliva, and put it on the blind man's eyes. Go, he told him, wash in the pool of Siloam. This word means sent. So the man went and washed, and came home, seeing. Mark 1:40-41. Now a leper came to him, imploring him, kneeling down to him and saying to him, "If you are willing, you can make me clean." Then Jesus, moved with compassion, stretched out his hand and touched him and said to him, "I am willing, be cleansed." Matthew 9:35. Jesus went, proclaiming the good news of the kingdom and healing every disease and sickness. Matthew 12:15. A large crowd followed him, and he healed all who were ill. Matthew 14:35-36. People brought all their sick to him and begged him to let the sick just touch the edge of his cloak, and all who touched it were healed. Isaiah 53:4-5. However, it was our sicknesses that he himself bore, and our pains that he carried. He was pierced for our offenses. He was crushed for our wrongdoings. The punishment of our well-being was laid upon him, and by his wounds we are healed. Matthew 8:16-17. Now when evening came, they brought to him many who were demon-possessed, and he cast out the spirits with a word and healed all who were ill. This happened so that what was spoken through Isaiah the prophet would be fulfilled. He himself took our illnesses and carried away our diseases. 1 Peter 2:24. He himself bore our sins in his body on the cross so that we might die to sins and live for righteousness. By his wounds you have been healed. Acts 10:38. And you know that God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and with power. Then Jesus went around doing good and healing all who were oppressed by the devil, for God was with him. Acts 5:15-16. Insomuch that they brought forth the sick into the streets and laid them on beds and couches, that at least the shadow of Peter passing by might overshadow some of them. There came also a multitude of the cities round about unto Jerusalem, bringing sick folks and them which were vexed with unclean spirits, and they were healed every one. Matthew 10:1-8. He called his 12 disciples to him and gave them authority to drive out evil spirits and to heal every disease and sickness. Heal the sick, raise the dead, cleanse those who have leprosy, drive out demons. Freely you have received, freely give. Mark 16:15-8. And he said unto them, "Go ye into all the world, and preach the gospel to every creature. He that believeth and is baptized shall be saved, but he that believeth not shall be condemned. And these signs shall follow them that believe. In my name they shall cast out devils. They shall speak with new tongues. They shall take up serpents. And if they drink any deadly thing, it shall not hurt them. They shall lay hands on the sick, and they shall recover." Acts 3:6-7. Then Peter said, "Silver or gold I do not have, but what I have I give you. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, walk." Taking him by the right hand, he helped him up, and instantly the man's feet and ankles became strong. 1 Corinthians 12:7-11. But the manifestation of the Spirit is given to every man to profit withal. For to one is given the Spirit the word of wisdom, to another the word of knowledge by the same Spirit, to another faith by the same Spirit, to another the gifts of healing by the same Spirit, to another the working of miracles, to another prophecy, to another discerning of spirits, to another divers kinds of tongues, to another the interpretation of tongues. But all these worketh that one and the same Spirit, dividing to every man severally as he will. Psalms 103:1-3. Praise the Lord, O my soul. All my inmost being, praise his holy name. Praise the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits, who forgives all your sins and heals all your diseases. James 5:14-15. Is any one of you sick? He should call the elders of the church to pray over him and anoint him with oil in the name of the Lord. And the prayer offered in faith will make the sick person well. The Lord will raise him up. Acts 20:8-9. His father was sick in bed, suffering from fever and dysentery. Paul went in to see him, and after prayer, placed his hands on him and healed him. When this had happened, the rest of the sick on the island came and were cured. Mark 16:17-18. And these signs will accompany those who believe. In my name they will drive out demons. They will speak in new tongues. They will pick up snakes with their hands. And when they drink deadly poison, it will not hurt them at all. They will place their hands on sick people, and they will get well. Acts 14:9-10. He listened to Paul as he was speaking. Paul looked directly at him, saw that he had faith to be healed, and called out, "Stand up on your feet." At that, the man jumped up and began to walk. Matthew 9:28-29. And after he entered the house, the men who were blind came up to him, and Jesus said to them, "Do you believe that I am able to do this?" And they said to him, "Yes, Lord." Then he touched their eyes, saying, "It shall be done to you according to your faith." Psalm 96:4-9. For great is the Lord, and greatly to be praised. He is to be feared above all gods, for all the gods of the peoples are idols. But the Lord made the heavens. Splendor and majesty are before him. Strength and beauty are in his sanctuary. Ascribe to the Lord, O families of the peoples. Ascribe to the Lord glory and strength. Ascribe to the Lord the glory of his name. Bring an offering and come into his courts. Worship the Lord in holy attire. Tremble before him, all the earth. John 86:12. Therefore, when he had gone out, Jesus said, "Now is the Son of Man glorified, and God is glorified in him." Psalm 115:1. Not to us, O Lord, not to us, but to your name give glory, because of your loving kindness, because of your truth. Psalm 118:28. You are my God, and I give thanks to you. You are my God, I extol you. Psalm 86:8-10. There is no one like you among the gods, O Lord, nor are there any works like yours. All nations whom you have made shall come and worship before you, O Lord, and they shall glorify your name. For you are great and do wondrous deeds. You alone are God. Psalm 69:30. I will praise the name of God with song and magnify him with thanksgiving. Psalm 82:12. I will give thanks to you, O Lord, my God, with all my heart, and will glorify your name forever. Isaiah 25:1. O Lord, you are my God. I will exalt you. I will give thanks to your name. For you have worked wonders, plans formed long ago with perfect faithfulness. John 14:3. Whatever you ask in my name, that will I do, so that the Father may be glorified in the Son. 2 Corinthians 4:13-15. But having the same spirit of faith, according to what is written, "I believed, therefore I spoke." We also believe, therefore we also speak, knowing that he who raised the Lord Jesus will raise us also with Jesus, and will present us with you. For all things are for your sakes, so that the grace which is spreading to more and more people may cause the giving of thanks to abound to the glory of God. Psalm 63:3. Because your loving kindness is better than life, my lips will praise you. Romans 11:33-36. Oh, the depth of the riches both of the wisdom and knowledge of God! How unsearchable are his judgments, and unfathomable his ways. For who has known the mind of the Lord? For who became his counselor? Or who has first given to him that it might be paid back to him again? For from him and through him and to him are all things. To him be the glory forever. Amen. Revelation 4:11. Worthy are you, our Lord and our God, to receive glory and honor and power. For you created all things, and because of your will they existed and were created.